Google have a brand new note-taking application, and it's not Google Keep. We're going to explore something called Notebook LM, which is a crazy powerful new tool from Google that has some really unique abilities. There is a feature in it that turns your notes into a podcast, and the AI voices on there and the conversation is pretty amazing. You can use it for study, research, journaling, whatever you want. And in today's video, we're going to cover all of those aspects and help to see whether Notebook LM is the future of note-taking and a note-taking application for you. Welcome everyone, my name is Francesco D'Alessio. Welcome to Toolfinder. If you're new here, do subscribe. And also, if you're interested to see all of the note-taking applications and how they're ranked, you can get a list of them below. And you can also get a buyer's guide to choosing the best note-taking application. If you're interested, link below. So let's start with the basics. What is Notebook LM? Because it has been out for, well, since July 2023, and very simply, it launched as a research project from Google. It is very much still in an experimental phase and currently only available through the web version, which we'll be demonstrating today. But the application was initially designed as a way to take a bunch of sources and allow you to communicate with that, very similar to typically like ChatGPT in terms of prompting and getting answers. However, it's evolved a lot since then, and we're going to be covering how you could potentially use it for research, study, and maybe even other aspects of your daily routine. But it's a really interesting application because it's Google's take on all of the information. Google state as well that they don't train your data from Notebook LM, which is very good news, but also it will allow you to use multiple sources now in a wide variety of ways. So let's jump over to the laptop to show you how it works in reality. So let's start with some of the basics. And this is what was available on the last version of Notebook LM. And it's very simply a chat-like experience. What you can do here is start having conversation with the sources that you've provided. So in this case, I've got four sources. They're all documents about the light bulb creation. And essentially you can select them on and off over on this left-hand side panel. Now, essentially you can use some of these pre-created prompts here, which extract some of the information and allow you to do it. In this case, I'm going to press this. And essentially what it's going to do is use all of those sources and reference some useful insights based on your questions. Now, obviously this can be really effective in terms of research, but also study too, in terms of pulling out some valuable information. So as you can see here, it's pulling out key information. For example, here, it's referenced some pieces in number 5, for example. And if I press that, what it's going to do is extract that information and where it got it from, all of these elements in the source guide, which is incredibly helpful. So obviously that's one aspect of it, and that's the chat and the communication. What if I want to add more sources? So sources obviously can be added on this left-hand panel. For example, if I go over to one of the notebooks I created called Fasting Research, I can add any resources I want to. So in this case, I can upload Google Docs, I can upload Google Slides, which is helpful. And you may notice down here, you've got like a bar to indicate how many limits of how many sources you can have. You can have up to 50, which is pretty impressive for what they're offering. Imagine adding 50 sources of information and bringing all that information in there. For researchers and study, that's pretty incredible. You can upload anything from a PDF to audio, MP3s, whatever it might be. Or you can use a website or a YouTube video or a copied text. So all of these sources can be added and then they appear on the left-hand panel. Now the pain with this is every time you add a source, for example here, it lives as a notebook. So you have to have a notebook for each separate experience you have. But that could be incredibly valuable for students that are adding sources over time or things that they find that they want to be able to pull information from. So like I said, you can ask questions if you want to and prompt it. But there's also this thing over here, and it looks like Google Keep, right? It's very ugly in my opinion. You click into it and these are notes that you can save. You can save notes or create notes from scratch, whatever the liking. And for example, if you were in here in the chat, for example, if I use this prompt here, then you can save any responses that you have in the chat, which is an incredibly helpful thing because it just means that you're saving the information they're pulling out in context. So here we go, I've got one. I can save it as a note and it will appear up here, which is fantastic. Now here's where the real magic kicks in. I can press two of these options. If I press one, it'll help me understand it through the chat function. But if I press two, it's gonna create a study guide or an outline or combine them into a note or summarize information or suggest related ideas, which is insane and crazy. And it's a great way to be able to pull in information and really start to drill down on two concepts that you may have saved or ask follow-up questions based on it. Now you can delete these or add notes. And as you can see, this is an empty note. For example, if I deselect all and click into this note, it's very much a basic note. As you can see, no frills, no spills, but if you're working in this sort of technology space, then they're probably focusing a lot more on the artificial intelligence side, as you can imagine. So this is where the real magic comes in. It's the notebook guide. Now here, it's sort of like a front page or your sources. It's really valuable because you can create them into an FAQ, you can turn them into study guide, table of contents, but it summarized everything based on all of the sources it's got here, which is incredibly valuable. So for example, you can see that it's pulled information that I had from Harvard, I believe that's up here, and then from the transcript of the video, which was about world's largest fasting study from Nutrition Facts. And it's brought in some suggested questions based on this. And what's really magical is what it's going to do is if I press load conversation, and I will let you know now, it does take some time to get set up. However, what it does is it pulls all of that information and turns it into a podcast. Now I'm going to play some of this on screen so that you can hear it and you can start to see how impressive this is.
Okay, seriously, is anyone else feeling like every time they open their phone, it's just article after article about intermittent fasting?
Right, like it's everywhere you look.
And it's not just the headlines, it's celebrities, it's those crazy before and after pictures, everyone's got an opinion.
And they all swear it's the best thing since sliced bread.
So what's really cool about this is it's already created this using artificial intelligence, which is amazing. And the accuracy of it, the way that it brings in all the sources and the way that it turns into a podcast-like approach, even you have people like laughing and overlaying information over the top of other people, which is interjecting, that's what it's called. Interjecting, which is incredible. And the one thing you can do straight away is actually change the playback speed or download it for your own likings. And that's created an almost 10-minute podcast for me. Now, why is this useful? If you're studying or researching and you're a audio-based thinker, that could mean something else, I don't know, not a visual thinker, then this might help you to reflect on the information that you've got. Incredibly useful for bringing together all the sources. Imagine if you had 50 sources and it brought together a podcast about it, which could be used as a way to consume the information on the go in the future, which is an incredible resource. So the audio overview is something that has recently been added, and you can add whatever you like, but it's quite cool. I tested some of the abilities. I was very impressed because I uploaded a journal, and I'm going to show you how that works in a moment. So that's the notebook guide. That's how it works over here. And that can be incredibly beneficial. So if I go back to my journal here, I just took some fake notes through ChatGPT and it created 4 journal entries about somebody finding it difficult to leave a job and start a new job and the anxiety around those elements. Now, as you can see, it's taken a source guide, summarizing it and picked out key topics, which is incredible already. But what it's done is it's created a notebook guide. And if I load the conversation, what it's going to do is provide me with a retrospective look from their perspective of how that person is feeling. In this case, it could be me, but they're having a conversation about their feelings. And I think that the dialogue that they create from this is pretty insane in terms of how they can look at the information.
Welcome back to the deep dive. You know, today we're doing something kind of different. We're diving deep into, well, your world.
Oh, intriguing.
Right. We've got these journal entries chronicling your lead up to a big career change. Last day's coming up fast.
I see. Following someone through this huge life transition, all those raw emotions. I'm ready when you are.
Exactly. A front row seat to your next chapter. And let me tell you, even just skimming these entries, it's a roller coaster. Excitement, apprehension, it's all there. What's your professional take on that cocktail of feelings?
Well, it's totally normal.
So obviously you need to be able to look at this and see whether something like this as a tool is right for you. Obviously it's important to be able to look at, you know, professional sources, not just artificial intelligence. If obviously the journal entries, you know, it's more of a retrospective look at things. But for example, let's say you had a marketing document and you uploaded some ideas and you were trying to get a feel for whether this strategy would work or not. That could be another aspect. But you can understand that that retrospective look of those feelings and elements that you bring to the table could be an incredible resource in journaling and prompting and building some of the thoughts out into a little bit more of a solid idea. For example, if I was actually feeling those elements between stuff, this gave me a really interesting audio dialogue about how I'm feeling based on how I have uploaded the information. So in my opinion, that's an incredible resource, and I was just playing around with the concept much more. Now, obviously this is completely experimental, so obviously you need to take it on the head. I found a few little hiccups in the dialogue, but they were really, really minor in terms of its overall experience. However, very, very impressed with how this can be offered out. Now, who is going to benefit from Notebook LM? Students, probably researchers, I probably wouldn't necessarily use it for a use case like this, or maybe even for marketing or sales. I'm not sure it can be incredibly valuable. However, insights on things that you bring in lots of sources from could be really, really helpful. So what does this mean for the future of note taking? Very simply, this is probably not going to be the finished article. They're likely going to bundle this up and put it into other experiences they've got, like Google Docs or Google Keep. They probably won't add an additional experience. This is more of a research product. So I wouldn't get fully integrated in this unless you're bringing sources from other places and you're not like reliant on all of these notebooks being yours, but it can be a great way to learn some information. Now, the way that I see it is note-taking is gonna go for a big shift in the next couple of years. Productivity administration is going to be completely wiped out, and anything that we did before that was manualized is going to be removed. And that's a good thing. It allows us to focus on the quality of the notes and the thinking of the notes versus actually the maintenance of the notes, which is incredibly useful. So think of a note-taking application that can bring in sources from your Gmail, can bring in sources from your Google Docs or other such places, and be able to know the things that are happening around you, the context that's important, to be able to provide you insights with your daily routine. It could have the conversations with business people, your friends' conversations, and also valuable tools and documents about your past, that it will be able to essentially amalgamate all of the insights and have a really interesting insight on your daily routine. Something that you can use as assistant every single day. So note-taking is almost falling down the assistant route, and it's going to be very exciting. I have a lot more thoughts on productivity AI and the future of it. So if you did want to sign up for my exclusive class or workshop that I'm going to dive into, the three parts of the future productivity world, then you can find that linked below. So hopefully it's helped you explore Notebook LLM, and explore Google's new note-taking application. I'll include a link to it below if you're interested, and I'll speak to you all very soon, and I look forward to you being subscribed. So I'll see you in the future video. Cheerio for now.